Okay, so today we will start with a new chapter in history, World During Modern Age. This you will find on page 5. You all have your books with you?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so open your books to page number 5, World During Modern Age. All right, so now before we start, can anyone here tell me, what is history?
Ma'am, history is the study of past.
Alright, so it is the study of past. Why do we need, if it is the study of past, then why we are supposed to study history?
Ma'am, to get some knowledge.
Alright, to get some knowledge. Is that all? Only to get knowledge? Is that all? You know what we are today?
Ma'am, it helps us knowing about the ancient things.
Okay, so that is somewhat the same thing that knowing about the past, till it helps us to know something about ancient and all that. Okay, but you know what we are today? It is because of our past. Alright, so to understand the present better, we need to go to the past. Alright, so to know today better, we need to go and study what happened in the past so that we learn from it, don't make the same mistakes, the mistakes that we did, and learn something from it. And also, you know, to know that if we are something today, then why are we that way? Or so basically, you know, to know our present better, and so that it helps us in our future also. For all that, we need to study history. Okay. Into how many periods is the history divided? History of
three.
India? Yes?
Ma'am, three.
Okay, which three periods?
Ma'am, ancient, medieval and modern.
Okay, ancient, medieval and modern. So, class 6th, you studied which history? Yes, we started this tour from class 6. So class 6 you studied ancient, medieval or modern. Which history you studied in class 6?
Ancient.
Alright, so you
Mom, ancient.
Yes, in class 6 you studied ancient. Alright, so in ancient history, can anyone tell me what you studied in ancient history? Anything you remember? Alright, so you studied about the early man, yes, and you studied about the different stone ages, you studied about the Paleolithic age, the Mesolithic and the Neolithic, right? Remember something about that?
Yes,
right. And you also studied about the early man, you know, first he used to live in caves and all that, and he was simply a hunter-gatherer, and then you studied more about him, that how gradually he settled down in one place, he learned farming and all that, and you even studied about the setting up of the first city and the first empire. You studied about the Mauryas and all that. Am I right?
Yes.
Alright.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Then last year you came to class 7th and you studied about which period in class 7th?
Medieval period.
Okay, so medieval period. What was different in medieval period from the ancient period? Can anyone tell me what was different? Why was this demarcation made? That okay, this is ancient period, and from here we have medieval period. What was that? That separates the ancient period and the medieval period. Yes, anyone knows? What was so special, what was different about the medieval period? Anyone?
Ma'am, the ancient period was different from the medieval period, ma'am, because they have started settling down and they have started praying to God, and they have, ma'am, the kings started making their kingdoms and new rules came up.
Okay. Alright. And you know, there was one thing more which was which marked the beginning of the medieval period. What we can say is, you know, the coming of the Muslim rulers to India, the Arabs and the Turks, they came to India, right? You
yes,
studied about the Muslim period and the Mughal period.
Yes, yes, ma'am.
All right. So you know, ancient period, we study about our past and we studied about the rulers who ruled during that period. But what makes the medieval period different is that from there, you know, that period starts generally from that time where the from where the Muslim and the Arab rulers, they came here and they started to rule here. Okay, and so you studied about all that in the last year. Now this year we'll be studying the modern period. All right, now we consider the modern period from the time, like you know, some consider it from the time that the Britishers they came here, and we have you know, colonial rule here. So many they consider that to be the beginning of the modern period. And you know, otherwise when we talk about modern, so when we say that someone is modern or something is modern, what do you understand by that term? Like sometimes, you know, we use the word she is very modern, or he is very modern, or this is modern. So what do you understand by that term? What do you mean by that term? Anyone here? Yes? You all never use this? Yes, beta.
Ma'am, relating to recent times or present time.
Okay. Means, you mean the contemporary time, the present time and all that. Okay, now, you know, when we talk about modern age, so you know, modern period, so what comes to our mind is that there was a scientific research, there was reasoning, and there was technological growth and advancement and all that. But you know, in India, people, they have a little bit they sometimes don't want to call this period as a modern period, because you know, in modern period we will have advancement and like I said, we will have the advancement of reasoning and science and technological progress and all that. So though we had that during that time, but you know, it is marred because during that time, you know, we were not free, we were under the control of the Britishers. So you know, many historians, they rather call this period as the colonial period, means when we were under the control of our colonial masters or the Britishers. So you know, this year we will study about the modern period. So we will start here with this chapter, and we learn that okay, what were the changes that were in the world, which you know, the things which brought about those changes. So we'll study about the Renaissance, we'll study about the Industrial Revolution, we'll study about American Revolution and French Revolution, the things that really brought about changes, all right, changes of ideas and thoughts, and which later on brought physical changes in the world in the modern period. So we'll study about that. In context of India, we will study about, you know, the establishment of the British rule here in India, and then how we as Indians, we finally came together, fought against them and gained our independence. So all that we will study during the course of this chapter this year. Okay, now, though the modern period, you know, it started in Europe first. So we say that it started in Europe in the 15th and the 16th centuries, but India being a colony, I will come to it later, colony, colonial, and I will explain it later on. Alright, now you know, it started later in India, much later, because you know, we were not a free country at that time, we were under the control of the Britishers. Now like I say that we were a colony, so what that means, we were under the political and economic control of some other power, greater power than us. So we were under their control, they were ruling over us, they were making decisions for us, they were governing us, and they also had control over our money and wealth. So that means that politically and economically we were under their control. So this modern period, it came later to India in the 18th and 19th century, whereas it started in Europe in the 15th and the 16th century. Now, how do we come to know about this modern period? So, you know, we have many sources through which we have information about this modern period. And now these sources can be divided into two categories, primary sources and secondary sources. Now, primary sources would be like literary sources, means literary would be what you can read, what is written down, so that is literary. And so literary sources, like we have the government reports and we have archives where all the reports and everything is saved. And then we have books, and we have paintings, and we also have some archaeological remains, like we also have some monuments of that period and some artifacts of this period. So all this comes under the primary sources. And now, so these are the primary sources that we have. Now, whatever people or the historians, they say about when they read these primary, when they study these primary sources. So when the historians study the primary sources, and what they say after that, now that makes the secondary sources. And so the secondary sources, they are available to us as reports, as reviews, articles and books. So let's have a look at some of the sources that we have of the modern period. So first we have the printed books of this period. Now, if you remember when you studied ancient history, all right, during class 6, so you know, the sources that we have of that period, they were not much written literary sources. And because, you know, at that time you studied about the Stone Age and all that, early man, he was still living in caves, people, they did not know language and all that much at that time, you know, through symbols and all, whatever they carved on the rocks, and that only we have. And then later on, you know, people, they started to like make symbols on these rocks, on the walls of the cave and all that. Then, you know, you move to the medieval period, and you have more number of sources of that period. And, you know, you have so many monuments and all that of the, and even inscriptions from the medieval period. And then you come to the modern period, and here, you know, the sources, the literary sources are innumerable. There are so many, because by that time printing press has already you know, been invented. And so books and everything, leaflets and magazines and everything could be written, newspapers could be printed and all. And so, you know, we have so many sources of the modern period. So because of the invention of the printing press during this period, so we have a lot of books, and that also in Indian languages and also in foreign languages, and which are available to us of this period. And they throw light on the various aspects of the people living during this period. And you know, these books, they also throw a great deal of light on the progress which was made by man in different fields during the modern period, like what advancement was made in the field of medicine and engineering, technology, art, literature, history, mathematics, means in various fields, what advancement was made during this period. Now we have all that with us. Then we even have government documents. So, you know, India is such a vast country, and you know, now we are one united country. And though, you know, we have a central government and state governments to rule the different states, But you know, we still are one united country. But you know, in our past, it was not so. And in different parts of the country, you know, different rulers, different dynasties ruled. And you know, all these rulers and their dynasties, they had their own documents and they had their own rules and regulations. And many times they exchanged these documents with each other. And you know, by these government documents, we easily get to know that how different powers they dealt with each other and how Britishers, they finally overcame all these powers one by one. So all that we get to know through this. And now these government documents, they also help us to know the true nature of the British rulers. All right, that what was the real nature? Were they really interested in the welfare of the people they were ruling, or they were only interested in filling their own pockets? So it also helps us to know the real nature of the of our British rulers. And they also tell us about the way the Britishers, they exploited our country. And now these government documents, they are a very important source of the history of modern India. Okay, so for today we will stop here. Were you all able to understand whatever little we did today?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.